the evolution of the World Wide Web. Hey guys, this is Dan Duran from GetCyber, and I'm thrilled to have you back for an exciting journey into the evolution of the World Wide Web. Grab a cup of coffee, relax, and let's dive into this fascinating topic. All right, so what's the World Wide Web, you ask? Well, it's like this incredible network of interconnected pages and resources that you can access through the internet. Over the years, it's gone through some major transformations, and we've labeled these phases as Web 1.0, Web 2.0, and Web 3.0. Each phase brought its own unique changes and challenges shaping the way we interact with the web and the technologies behind it. Let's kick things off with Web 1.0. Think of it as the web's early days, its infancy. Back then, it was pretty basic, mostly read-only. You could browse static web pages, and they typically contained text, images, and links. Forget about social media or any sort of real-time interaction. It was all about consuming information. During the Web 1.0 era, some of the big players included Yahoo, AOL, eBay, Netscape, and GeoCities, among others. Yahoo was like your friendly neighborhood search engine and web portal, offering a directory of websites, news, email, and other services. Then there was AOL, short for America Online, a pioneer in internet service providers. They specialized in dial-up internet access and bundled it with services like email and instant messaging. You might even recall those iconic
"You've got mail"
messages when you logged in. Now, let's fast forward to Web 2.0. This was like the web's adolescence, a period of interactive, user-generated content. The web became more dynamic and social. We saw the rise of social media platforms, blogs, wikis, and various collaborative tools. Suddenly, users weren't just passive consumers. They were creators and contributors. And just like any other creator, like and smash the subscribe button to get more awesome content. Here's something fascinating about Web 2.0. It empowered users to actively participate in creating and sharing content. It's like the internet turned into a massive playground where everyone could join in. Some cool examples include Amazon, Facebook, Airbnb, Uber, and Netflix. What's intriguing is that these giants didn't actually own the stuff they dealt with. For instance, Amazon, the world's highest volume merchant, didn't have a massive inventory. Airbnb, the king of accommodation providers, didn't own properties. Even Facebook, the biggest media company, didn't create most of its content. And Netflix, the giant movie house, didn't own movie theaters.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Personalization was another key feature of Web 2.0. Websites wanted to cater to your preferences, making your online experience more tailored. Artificial intelligence, AI, began to play a crucial role in recommendation systems, targeted advertising, and custom content delivery. It was all about giving users what they wanted, right when they wanted it. Oh, and don't forget about the rise of mobile devices. As smartphones and tablets became mainstream, websites had to adapt. They started optimizing their designs for various screen sizes and touch-based interactions. It was all about making the web experience seamless and enjoyable on the go. Now let's move on to the shiny new kid on the block, Web 3.0. It's like the web's adulthood marked by advanced technologies. Web 3.0 is all about artificial intelligence, blockchain, and the Internet of Things, IoT. Artificial intelligence is the superstar here. Web 3.0 leverages AI techniques like machine learning, deep learning, natural language processing, and massive language models to understand content in depth. It's like the web is getting smarter, able to grasp the meaning and context of online content. This means you'll get more personalized, relevant information and services delivered right to your virtual doorstep. Now, let's talk about blockchain. It's a game changer. Blockchain technology is all about decentralization and security. Instead of data being stored on a single central server, it's distributed across a network of computers called nodes. This decentralization makes it incredibly resistant to control by a single authority. Plus, blockchain technology ensures top-notch security, making it super hard for unauthorized parties to tamper with transaction data. It's like the internet's own vault. But that's not all. Web 3.0 also ushers in the era of the Internet of Things, or IoT. Picture this. The internet is now connected to the physical world through sensors. Web 3.0 technologies use a combination of edge computing, cloud computing, and super-fast 5G networks to offer seamless, lightning-fast access to online services and apps across various devices and locations. And if that's not cool enough, Web 3.0 aims to provide immersive and interactive experiences like 3D graphics, virtual reality, holograms, and augmented reality. It's like stepping into a whole new dimension when you're online. But here's the thing. Web 3.0 isn't entirely here yet. It's like a sneak peek into the future, with elements slowly making their way into our internet experiences. It's bound to bring some major changes, and I, for one, can't wait to see how it all unfolds. So there you have it, the incredible journey of the World Wide Web from its early days in Web 1.0 to the interactive Web 2.0 and the futuristic Web 3.0. Thanks for joining me on this adventure. Stay tuned for more exciting updates, and don't forget to subscribe.